Streaming service, Golden Shovels Made for TV by Sofía Aguilar. Published by Sofía Aguilar. Copyright 2021 by Sofía Aguilar. SofíaAguilar.com. All rights reserved. No part of this book may be reproduced or used in any manner without permission of the copyright owner except for the use of quotations in a book review. For more information, address saguilar@gm.slc.edu. First edition, cover and content design by Sofía Aguilar. Author's note. The Golden Shovel poem was first invented by American poet and educator Terence Hayes when he wrote The Golden Shovel, 2010, after poet Gwendolyn Brooks' poem We Real Cool, 1959. To replicate the form, simply take a line or several from another poem, book, film, television show, or any piece of media that you choose, set each word on its own line on the page, and make them either the first or final word of each line of your new poem, filling in your own language. If done correctly, you'll be able to follow the original line or lines down the edge of the new poem. As you read through the poems in this collection, read them first in the form as presented on the page, then go back and read the last word of each line or sentence, or vice versa. And you may find a new conversation between my words and the original dialogue begin to emerge. The only exception to this rule is in Sophie, which cherry-picked its last words from its source material, full list in the end credits, and may not make complete sense the entire way through. But for me, this only added to the fun. Prima, for Polly. Back then, you and I weren't old enough yet, but we've always been good at wanting what breaks us deep inside, happens like a bruise, sweeter looking than it tastes when claiming lovers, secretly. If our mothers weren't there seeing us, looking too close, as if they were the only loves we'd ever deserve, the ones we'd stitch our bones to, bodies of thread and needle more than skin. Not me, but us. Not I, but we want. Who cares what would be left of for ourselves? But what if I don't want to make my voice small or curl myself like a worry? Prima, what if someday soon I hope I delight in myself as deeply as you, my palm, my mouth, can turn my pain into power no one else can take. Settle into my solitude with care, shoulder the letters of my love as though a child of my own. You, always, the best of myself. Good love. I wasn't born sinking into my own shallowness. This soft belly, stretch mark thighs, blackheads forming a maze. I always longed for beauty and didn't believe it was mine, compared our bodies all the time. Why can't I look like them? Everyone else I see. Why does it hurt so badly to be me? This self-made disdain as hateful as record heat in summer's height, the burn sore, searching to be soothed, wishing for the day I'd begin refusing, turning away, saying no to the voices inside, growing out of this shame into a softness calmer than the sea, still and steady as summers of the dandelion kind, caught in the spine bone of a blue-streaked day. Even when the men declare it isn't right, envy this tenderness for once not made for them, still I choose to worthy myself a good love like a song on full volume.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.